Hey everybody, Sean McInnes here alongside Patrick Bach from DICE, who's here to tell us about Battlefield 3. Patrick, I think it's fair to say the military first-person shooter has just really exploded in popularity over the past 3 years. Battlefield a big part of that. So what are you guys doing to make sure that Battlefield 3 stands out in this genre? Because it must not be an easy thing to do.
Yeah, first-person shooters are extremely popular today, and what we're doing at DICE when we build our Battlefield games is actually look at our own games. Because Battlefield is a sport for us, so we see it as something in the core that we can't change, because we don't want it to change, because that would then turn into another game. So we always look back at our history and trying to build the best possible Battlefield game, and that's what we do.
I've just had the pleasure of seeing a demo for Battlefield 3, and all I can say is, wow, this game looks good. So tell us, everybody out there, what sort of upgrades have you guys done to the engine, to the tech, to make this game look so impressive?
I think the big change with the engine is that we rewrote it from scratch. We actually threw away the old engine, because when we looked at what we wanted to build with Battlefield 3, we couldn't build it with an existing engine. So we have to rebuild it from scratch. Everything is brand new, the rendering, the streaming technology, the audio, everything. So, and of course that combined with a very talented team creates the magic of Battlefield 3.
Now, as you said on stage, tech can only do so much. What really matters is how the game plays, what the experience is like. So tell us, what does that mean in gameplay terms? How is this game going to feel like a huge upgrade?
I think the word feel is exactly what we're trying to get to. You know, you want to create a very visceral experience. And of course, everyone says that, but can you actually deliver on it? We're using a lot of, you know, tricks that we've learned over the past years. Of course, one thing is the animation system that was, you know, brand new. You know, we took the technology from EA Tech, which delivered it for the sports titles, but that's a flat ground with, you know, 11 versus 11. And this is a first-person shooter, so it took quite some time to you know, turn that into, you know, I would argue, the best animation systems for any first-person shooter on the market today. So, you know, there's a lot of tricks that we use. Animation is one of them.
Now, destruction is an element that you guys introduced with Bad Company. It's become a huge part of that series, and it looks like it's making the transition over to Battlefield 3, right?
Yes. We've noticed when we developed the Bad Company series that destruction actually works as not only a visual element, but also as a tactical element. And adding that to the mix in the core Battlefield series will actually make Battlefield into an even more tactical game. So I think Even though it looks amazing when you blow things up, it actually adds to the gameplay. It actually changes how you play the game every match. So I think that would be a huge improvement to the core Battlefield series.
So, you know, Patrick, while we're on the subject of Bad Company, with that series, you guys really focused on characters and personality to deliver a story, you know, delivering the story through their eyes and their experience. Are you guys going to do something similar with Battlefield 3, or are you guys taking a different route with storytelling?
I won't really go into details on the story or the storytelling, but in general, you know, we are not connected to the Battlefield Bad Company series with Battlefield 3. So we actually have a very, you know, tabla rasa to just start from scratch and to create the same emotion that we had in the Battlefield 2 game, but turning that into a campaign. So of course it will be more realistic, it will be more hardcore, more, you know, rough. And like you saw in the demo, it doesn't feel anything like the Bad Company series.
Besides just the story, is there anything else that you guys learned from the Bad Company series that you were applying to this game? Because, you know, prior to that series, you guys were mainly focused on multiplayer, and you guys learned a lot about campaigns through Bad Company.
I think campaign is one big thing, but also looking at how the world has actually evolved since Battlefield 2. You know, everything from persistence to rendering to audio, you know, we've been taking quite big leaps in the Bad Company series since we've built Battlefield 2. So we're of course taking a lot of that knowledge into Battlefield 3. So I think both the fans from the Battlefield 2 game and the Bad Company fans will actually love this game.
Well, Patrick, as I mentioned, the game looks fantastic. I'm excited to see it. I know I'm probably not the only one. So can you finish us off by letting us know, when is Battlefield 3 going to be out in stores?
Battlefield 3 will be in the stores this fall on PC, 360, and PS3.
Patrick, thanks a lot. There you guys have it. Battlefield 3 coming out later this year.